This is another thing. Don't underestimate your audience. You know, you never know when they're gonna see like, oh, okay, I want that.
Good morning and hello everyone. Welcome to Virtual Coffee Break with Bublup. I'm your host, Wade Sellers, and today we are with the one and only Laura Peruchi. Good morning, Laura. How are you?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for having me.
I'm happy that you're here. I'm stoked you're here. We're in New York City. This is a special virtual coffee break. We've been doing Zoom calls with the pandemic. If you don't know Laura Peruchi, she is a YouTuber. She is a blogger. She talks all about New York City, tips, tricks, secret spots, all that.
Yeah.
And she does it in Portuguese for a Brazilian audience, right?
Yes.
I love that. Are you from Brazil?
Yeah, I'm from Brazil and I've been living in New York for almost 7 years, actually 6 years and a half.
6 years. So you definitely know your New York City quite well.
Yes.
Well, I wanted to talk to you today because you're crushing it on YouTube. I see the blogs. You're doing fantastic. I assume that there are multiple income streams coming in because this is your full-time business, right?
Yes.
This is your full-time work?
It is.
And I wanted to ask you about like income streams and how you make money and kind of talk to you about how you started out, maybe how you started to begin making money, and then maybe what you might suggest other people might want to look into if they're looking to start a blog or go on YouTube,
mm-hmm.
and how they might make a couple bucks at it in the beginning to get it started.
Yeah.
So when you were getting started with your YouTube channel, you started to figure out some income streams or ways to monetize it. What kind of ways did you go? What did you get into first?
So I think the safest way to start to earn some money on the internet is go through affiliate links.
Okay.
And there are a lot of affiliate platforms for influencers. So basically for me, for example, I can go to Empire State Building and I can say, look at this view, it's amazing, you should come here. And then I put an affiliate link for people to buy the ticket to mm-hmm. go to Empire State Building.
Yeah.
Or maybe I can talk about this new mug. Oh, I bought this mug on Amazon. Here's the link mm-hmm. if you want to buy something. So basically, I would say like everything that you talk about, there is an affiliate link.
Mm-hmm.
So start to put those affiliate links on everything that you create, like a blog post or a video, and make sure to let your audience know. And don't be shy mm-hmm. to tell your audience like, please use my link so you support what I'm doing. So don't be shy to tell your audience that.
Mm-hmm. I think it comes across as honest and just transparent to say, hey, I'm providing that value to you. This
yeah.
is a service. I have to make money to do it in order to continue to do it.
Yeah.
So therefore, if you are interested in this, all you have to do is click this one thing. Now, you were going to go Google it anyways, but you know, if you do it my way or through
yes.
my direction, then you help
yes.
me out at the same time.
Yes.
Do you think about something that you can sell before you make the video and then build a video around it? Or do you kind of go, which direction does it go?
It depends, actually. Mm-hmm. It depends on the content. Now, if I'm talking about restaurants in the city, I can definitely put a link below saying, if you want to buy tickets for attractions in New York or Broadway shows, please check my link. So it's kind of all related when you are talking about travel. So about the content, it depends. It depends what I'm gonna do. So another day I was recommending some books about New York, like not tourist books.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought like, okay, I can talk about these books and also put my affiliate link. So it depends. It depends, like the creation process is different depending on the topic.
So you said affiliate links were the way to go. Would you suggest that's like the first place you start? Is it pretty easy barrier of entry to get into?
Yes. I mean, not all the platforms. There are mm-hmm. some platforms that are hard to get into because you need to present some numbers, but there are tons of affiliate platforms.
Okay.
So you just apply to wherever you can. I try to be in a lot of platforms, you know?
Cool.
So I have for tickets, for the New York City attractions, I have for Broadway tickets, I have for beauty products,
mm-hmm.
because I also talk about some beauty products, I have the Amazon. So try to be in a lot of affiliate platforms, and every time that you can put a link, put a link. There's a funny story. When I moved to this apartment, mm-hmm. which was 3 months ago, people in Brazil are so curious about things that happen in the United States when you live abroad. So they ask me, how do you clean the apartment? You know, like,
they want to know how you keep them clean.
How you keep it clean. And then I show like that I have this thing that you spray the water and you clean it. I actually, a follower, and she came to the city. She bought it because she saw my story. So this is another thing. Don't underestimate your audience. You never know when they're going to see like, oh, okay, I want that.
Yeah.
So try to put a link on everything.
So like nothing's out of the realm. You say, this is something I use.
I talk about tourism, but people are interested to know about other things in my daily basis, on my daily routine. So I put that and people bought it.
I love that. Okay, so we've got affiliate marketing. Is there any other service that might be great for if you're just getting started out, you're just trying to get your feet wet and find a spot to make a couple bucks?
So for me, the tourism industry and working with Brazilians, I find another way to earn some money working with some partners. I realized a lot of people when come to New York, they want a Brazilian driver mm-hmm. waiting for them at the airport.
Okay.
So I have partnerships with some Brazilian drivers.
That's so smart.
Sometimes they pay me commissions or they pay like a price fix and they are in the part of my website where I have all these resources, you know, so you basically go to my website and you're gonna find everything that you need. So we have Brazilian drivers. You can sell like an advertising on your website, mm-hmm. like a marketplace for the audience, you know. So I have all these people that work in the tourism industry in New York that work with me, mm-hmm. you know, we have this partnership.
I love that. Do you establish that partnership by do you go find Portuguese speaking drivers and say, hey, I have an audience that might be coming to America from Brazil. Would you be interested in working together with me or do they come to you? How's this work?
So at the beginning, so everything started actually on a community on okay. Facebook. So I was using that to drive attention to my blog. Mm-hmm. These people that work in New York started to get into the group. And then at a certain point I realized, okay, maybe I should monetize this.
Yeah.
And then I started to do this partnership. So I say, hey, I know that you are getting a lot of customers using my platform, so let's work together. Mm-hmm. Some of them want it, some of them didn't want it,
sure.
but you keep trying. And now that I have a huge presence in the internet because of the New York City platform, they find me.
Mm-hmm. And now they say, I have a service that your audience might be
yes.
interested in, and then
yes.
they come to you to work for it. But
yes.
in the beginning, you
yes.
were kind of hustling to get
yes.
their attention.
Yes.
And now that you've got the audience,
yes.
they, okay, that's great.
Game change.
I love that. Is there any spot where Bublup fits into your overall
yeah.
archer? Like, how
wow.
do you get into
of
it?
Of course, a lot of things. So one thing that I suggest when you are creating content, mm-hmm. it's like, listen to your audience. Always, because you're gonna get so many ideas because you know what they want. So I realized that they want a suggestion, and then I put together all my recommendations for the holiday season in New York, like restaurants, parties, things that you should not miss, like the decorations,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
or maybe the Radio City, the Rockettes, you know?
Which is why they pay attention to you, because
yeah.
you know all these things.
Yes, so I put together, I think it was like 40 pages,
oh.
and I put it for free on my Bublup folder.
Mm-hmm.
And another thing that I did, I put a lot of affiliate links on this ebook
mm-hmm.
that I provide for free, and I also put at the beginning of the ebook, I said like, okay, this is like my gift to you. I worked so hard on this. So please, if you're gonna buy something, please use my links
yeah.
because all these links are affiliates and this way you are supporting me and I can do this next year.
And
yeah.
it has that takeaway factor. They're actually
yeah.
out and about and it's
yeah.
like, what was that thing she said? Oh yeah, it's right there.
Yes.
Yeah, right?
Yes.
Okay, I like that. That's cool.
Yeah.
Laura, you are absolutely full of information when it comes to how to make a couple bucks while you're doing this YouTube and blog thing, which is, I just absolutely love. There's so many avenues you can go. And I really love that you are very contextual with yours. Like, how does my audience value from the information I'm giving them?
Yes.
And then you've created pieces and products that you can offer to them. So
yes.
super cool. Laura, thank you so much for having
thank
me
you.
Over.
Thank
Cheers
you.
To you.
Cheers.
And we will hope to have you back on Virtual Coffee Break again.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
See ya.